Oh man, I don't want to mess this up.
Hey Junior, what you doing?
Yeah, dude.
I'm trying to put the screen protector on my phone.
Well, it's always good to use protection.
Ooh, if my parents used protection, they wouldn't have had me.
Same.
Guys, I just don't want to mess this up. I only have one chance to put it on.
Dude, I suck at putting screen protectors on.
I'm great at it.
What, you are?
Oh yeah, it's really easy.
Well, can you put it on for me?
Yeah, sure. Alright, Junior, so the trick to putting on screen protectors is to just slap it down really fast and don't think about it.
But don't think about it!
No, because if you think about it, then you're gonna get nervous, and that's when you start to make mistakes.
I guess that makes sense.
Okay, now watch a master do it. Alright, you just kinda line it up and BAM!
What, Cody, you put it on sideways!
Well, yeah, I just wanted to show you how not to do it. Okay, what? So we're just gonna take this and peel it off. Okay, and then we're gonna do it for real.
But Cody, you're not even putting it on right!
Well, you know what it is? It's this shirt. That's the problem.
The shirt?
Yeah, it's like really tight and it's restricting my arm movement and it's just in the way. I'm gonna go take my shirt off. Yeah, okay, Daddy's ready. It's gonna be way easier now that I don't have that disgusting shirt on me.
Dude, how does the bow tie stay on?
Oh, it's drilled on.
What, drilled on?
Yeah, you can drill stuff into walls as long as you find a stud. And I'm one big stud.
Oh, Cody, can you just put the screen protector on right?
Yeah, it'll be way easier this time. Okay.
Cody, you're not even close!
Okay, I got it.
Cody, you're not even trying!
I'm trying, okay? I'll do it. Just watch.
You know, I'll just do it.
What, no, Junior, it's these shorts. That's the problem. They have to come off, too.
What, no, Cody, you know, I'm just gonna do it myself. You know what?
Junior, just let me do it.
What? Cody, you just broke my screen protector! Cody, that cost like $50! Now I have to go ask my dad for more money, and I don't even think he's gonna give me any. Cody, say something! Dad?
What do you want, Junior? I'm trying to take a nap!
You know that screen protector you just bought me?
Yeah, what about it?
Cody broke it trying to put it on my phone.
Dang it, Junior! That's a $50 screen protector! Why aren't you more careful? That's all you have to say? Look, Junior, I guess I'll spend $50 more on the screen protector instead of spending thousands of dollars on a whole new phone if you were to break that one.
Wait, you'll buy me a new screen protector?
Yeah, I guess so.
Wait, where's your wallet?
What, wallet? Look under my bed!
Look under your bed. What? Dad! Why do you have so much money under your mattress?
Junior, ever since I was 18, I've been stuffing my mattress with cash so the IRS wouldn't find my money.
Oh, that's a really smart idea, Dad.
I know, so get what you need. Get a $100 bill and bring my change back, okay?
Okay. Thanks, Dad.
Don't tell anybody about my cash. I don't want Chef Pee-Pee thinking he can get paid now.
Okay. I accidentally took
it. Yeah, don't say too much.
Okay, thanks, Dad. Guys! My dad gave me money for a new screen protector!
Dude, $100?
I didn't know your dad was loaded. I mean, I knew he was a DILF, but I didn't know he was a sugar daddy, too.
No, guys. I mean, this is like all he had in his wallet. It's not like he has like $1,000 stuffed under his mattress or anything.
That's kind of specific, Junior.
Yeah.
Wait, guys, you're like questioning me. Like, you're acting like he like sleeps like on $1 million under his bed, like he's hiding from the IRS or something.
Dude, do you have something to say to us?
Yeah, does he?
What, no, guys, look, I'm gonna go buy a new screen protector, and I have to give my dad back the change, because he's not rich or anything. He's really poor, and he's gonna give me back the change. Like, this is supposed to be our money for our food this week, but he said go get a screen protector. All right, guys, I got another screen protector.
All right, let Daddy get to work.
No, Daddy's not gonna get back to work, because you broke the last one.
Well, at least he called me Daddy.
Well, no, look, I'm gonna call a professional company to put the screen protector on my phone.
You just love wasting money, don't you?
Well, then you wasted money because you broke my last one. That was $50. You just wasted money.
But, Junior, I told you the shorts were the problem. Just let me take my shorts out.
No, the shorts have nothing to do with it. Look, I'm gonna call a professional company.
Okay, fine. I'll go look at myself in the mirror.
Hey there, somebody called Dr. Screen Protector?
Yeah. Why do they call you Dr. Screen Protector?
Oh, because I'm like a surgeon because of how precise I am with putting screen protectors on phones.
You're that good?
Oh, yeah, I'm great. I got a PhD in screen protective putting on-ning. I wanted to be a screen protective putter-on my entire life. You know, I come from a long line of screen protective putter-oners. My great-great-grandfather put the first screen protector on the first screen.
But he did?
Yeah, our last name was actually gonna be Screen Protective Putter-Oner. But, you know, that's kind of hard to fit on a license, so we just changed it to Guy, you know, because people were always like, who's that guy who puts screen protectors on phones? And then, yeah, we were like, oh, Guy, yeah, that's good. So we changed it to Guy. Anyway, where's the patient?
Patient?
Yeah, your phone.
Oh, it's right here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I see that. Now, where's the screen protector? Is this it? Whoa, what happened here?
Oh, my friend tried to put a screen protector on my phone.
Oh, yeah, that's what happens when you do some amateur screen protector puttering awning. Yep. I hate to see it. All right, let's go to the operating room.
Okay.
Okay, vitals are good. He looks healthy.
Oh, please take care of him, doctor.
Oh, don't worry. I'm a professional. I've done this hundreds of times before. Now, the first thing we want to do is make sure the screen is nice and clean. We're just going to wipe it down, Okay, there you go. That looks good. And then we're gonna take this thing.
But what is that?
This is the screen protector putter on a helper. Yeah, screen protector putter on a helper. We're just gonna put that on there, right there. Just put it on nice and tight.
Okay.
Okay, that should be good. Now, we take the screen protector and very carefully.
Oh, careful.
Very carefully, just put it on. Make sure it fits nice and snug right in there. Okay, that looks good. And now, we gently peel this back. There we go. And pop this off. Well, bam, bam. There you go.
But what about all those air bubbles? See, look at all those air bubbles.
Don't panic. Don't panic. I can take care of those. We just got to get something really heavy and put it on top of the phone.
Wait, something really heavy? Well, my friend Cody, his mom's like 500 pounds.
No. We need something heavy. And believe me, if we needed a heavy person, we'd just get my ex-wife. Because she is so fat. So damn fat. No, it's okay. Just follow me outside.
Okay.
Okay, just put this under here.
Well, what are you doing?
I'm gonna run it over with my car.
Well, you're gonna break the phone!
I'm not gonna break the phone, dummy. There's a screen protector on there.
But this is a 3,000-pound car. It's gonna break the screen protector and the phone.
Well, look, what's the point of having a screen protector on the screen if it's not gonna protect the screen?
But I think it's gonna break it.
It's not gonna break it, okay? We just gotta squeeze out that little air bubble and we need that weight, okay? So don't worry about it. Look, who's the screen protector doctor here?
You.
Me, exactly. So I'm just gonna put this down here, and I'm gonna run it over.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna run this bad boy over.
Then why aren't you in your car?
Oh, because I have a Hyundai Sonata. A 2021 Hyundai Sonata. A 2021 Hyundai Sonata in a stormy sea blue.
What does that mean?
What it means is that I have park assist, so I can run over your phone without even being in the car.
Wait, really? Like there's no one in the car?
There's no one in the car. I can just do it right here from my key fob. Watch this. Hold on. It's going up. You hear that? Here it comes. Here it comes. Here we go. It's doing it. Yeah. There you go.
What, it did?
Yeah. I ran over it.
Let's check and see if the air bubbles are out.
Okay. Yeah, well, that air bubble's still on there.
Well, but we just ran it over.
No, it's okay. We'll run it over a few more times. Not a problem.
We'll check the back.
Oh, don't look at the back.
Show me the back.
No, you don't want to see the back.
Show me the back. What? You broke my phone!
No, you broke your phone.
What did you ran it over?
Well, you didn't have a screen protector on the back. That's not my fault. Bye.
Now I gotta get a new phone and my dad's gonna be mad! Ugh. Guys!
Dude, what happened to your phone?
Yeah, Junior.
The guy put the screen protector on it.
What? How do you mess it up that bad?
Well, after he put the screen protector on it, there were air bubbles, so he tried to get the air bubbles out by running it over with a car.
That's not how you get air bubbles out.
I know, and now my phone's broken, and I don't know how I'm gonna get a new phone.
Dude, just ask your dad for some money.
Yeah, he gave you $100 like it was nothing.
Yeah.
But he gave me the $100 for a new screen protector, so he wouldn't have to buy me a new phone. If he finds out my phone's broken, he's gonna ground me.
Well, but if he can afford to give you $100, then he can afford to buy you a new phone.
Guys, I got something to tell you.
What is it, dude?
Do you have certain feelings whenever you see me without my shirt?
No. My dad has, like, a bunch of money stuffed under his mattress.
Whoa, really, dude?
How much?
I don't know. It could be, like, $1 million, or it could be just enough to hang off the side to make it look like there's a lot of money under the bed.
Ooh.
I don't know. I really need the money, but I can't ask my dad for it because he'll ground me.
Dude, just take it. Look, it's a lot of money under the bed, right? Just take the money. He's not going to know.
Well, Joseph, that would be stealing.
Who cares, Cody?
Joseph's right. I should just go there. My dad would never notice the money's missing, so I'm just going to go in there and take the money.
I think you should just ask him.
No. He won't notice $1,000 missing. One, two, three... Four.
Better not be stealing my money!
Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine.
Who goes there?
10. All right, guys, I grabbed $1,000.
Wow, you weren't lying. He really does have a lot of money under his mattress.
Dude, you should have took more.
Well, I just grabbed enough to get a new phone, so I'm gonna go ask Chef Pee Pee if he can take me to the store.
Wait. You didn't need anybody to take you to the store when you got the screen protector.
Huh.
My candy souffle is almost done.
Chef Pee Pee!
What do you want, Junior?
Can you take me to the store to buy a new phone?
Wait, where did you get all that cash from?
Don't stay under my dad's mattress. Don't stay under my dad's mattress.
Wait, what did you just say?
Definitely not under my dad's mattress. Dang it.
Your dad has cash under his mattress?
No, I didn't say he had $1,000 stuffed under his mattress. I didn't say that.
He has to. He doesn't pay me any money, so he probably has cash under his mattress.
But he doesn't, Chef Pee Pee, and if you go look and see it, don't say you heard it from me.
You know what? I'm gonna go and check.
No, Chef Pee Pee, don't check. Oh, dang it. Who's gonna take me to the store?
Oh my god, look at all this cash. Oh yeah, I'm about to steal all of this. Wait, what's that noise? Chappie, what are you doing in my room?
Nothing.
Wait, are you stealing money from under my mattress?
No, not yet.
Well, I'm about to count all my cash, because I know exactly what's under my mattress. And if you stole even a dollar from me, I'm gonna blame you for it!
What's wrong, Junior?
I accidentally told Chef Pee Pee about the money under my dad's mattress.
No, no.
Wait, where's Joseph?
Oh, he said he was out of here, dude, and then he took my shirt and ran off. That's okay. It was too tight for me anyway.
Hey, guys! Say goodbye to Chef Pee Pee!
What, goodbye to Chef Pee Pee? Why?
He stole $1,000 from me, so now he has to go swimming with the fishes. I didn't steal money from you! Well, who did, then?
Ahem.
What?
Junior.
What?
Don't you think you should tell him you stole the money?
I would get grounded.
Yeah, but would you rather Chef Pee Pee died?
Well, I don't want to get grounded.
Junior, it'll just be for the rest of the video. Do the right thing. Make up your mind. Junior? Oh God, he's stuck.
Help me! Help me!
Junior!
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Junior!
Oh,
just look that way!
Okay, thank you. Okay. Dad?
What do you want, Junior?
I have something to tell you.
What?
Chef Pee Pee didn't steal the money.
Wait, who did then?
It was me.
Junior, why did you steal money from me?
Well, I needed a new phone. My phone broke.
But the screen protector, Junior! The screen protector!
There wasn't one on the back, and I didn't want to ask you because I didn't want you to get mad, so I stole the money.
Well, I'm more mad that you stole money from me. You should have just asked for it, Junior.
That's what I said.
So what's my punishment?
20 spankings.
Wait, but what's his punishment, though?
20 spankings.
Wait, you get spanked as a punishment?
Yeah.
I want that punishment.
So you'll take this punishment for me?
Yeah, spank me.
Dad, Cody said he'll take the spankings for me.
All right, come on. I don't care who gets it.
All right. Come on, Daddy. Let's get it.